Hi there. Welcome to the 6th Media Express vlog. My name is Sven Bladschorre and I'm Commercial Solution Manager for airports. Today we will see how data can be used in the world of airport operations. We received many questions on how condition monitoring can be used to prevent downtime and how it actually works. And for that we will meet with 4 experts. One of them is Rutger Stolker. He's one of our service development consultants. So let's go. Hey, Rutger.
Hey.
Hi, how are you?
Good.
Hey, we're looking into condition monitoring. Can you help us to explain what that is?
Sure. Wouldn't it be great if the operation and maintenance team is automatically informed when to replace a part before that part actually breaks?
Well, that would be perfect.
Yeah, and even more, the team is informed about the actual system state and its operational performance. That is what we call predictive operations, and condition monitoring is one of the techniques to make that possible.
And can you explain how that will work?
Condition monitoring is actually measuring the asset condition using sensor technology. And Erik van den Bos, one of our reliability engineers, can tell you all about it.
Okay, hey, thanks Rutger. I'm going to look for Erik. Hi, Erik. How are you?
Hey, Sven. How are you? I'm good.
Hey, we're looking into condition monitoring. And can you tell us what your role is in that?
Sure. As a reliability engineer, I translate the customer KPIs into a service concept. And one of the most important customer KPIs is unplanned downtime. And condition monitoring is one of the most efficient and effective ways to reduce unplanned downtime. And in my role, I find out which are the most critical assets in the system and which parameters we need to monitor to see how we can reduce the unplanned downtime. And of course, this is always done in close cooperation with the customer.
Okay. Hey, I see here a dashboard. Here I see a parameter in orange. What does that mean?
Yeah, this is one of the assets that we are looking into. So in the past 24 hours, you see that certain attention value has reached its limits, but still currently it's in green. So let's look into the details of that. What you see here is the results of the past measurements of this particular sensor. And you see that it has reached its attention value at some point in time, but still the limit value has not reached, so it's still safe.
Okay, but it means that the maintenance engineer needs to do a further inspection.
Yes, that's a possibility.
Okay, yeah, very interesting. Thank you very much, Erik.
You're welcome.
See you. Another question that we received is, how can condition monitoring help to prevent operational downtime? And I know just the right guy who can help us with this. You might recognize him from an earlier vlog. Frans, thanks for making time for us.
Of course.
We just had a look at the condition monitoring dashboard. And I wonder, how will that work in the control room of an airport?
Yeah, good question. Let me show you how we integrate condition monitoring into Vibes. Condition monitoring alerts are shown in our integrated status overview, like this.
And what can an operator do when he receives such a notification?
Because this is a warning, the operator can keep using the system. For example, if a peak is expected. And the operator can request overnight maintenance.
So this gives much more operational stability to the airport.
Indeed.
And of course, we all want to know how condition monitoring works in practice. And for that, we will go to Sharon Deyora, our colleague from our Singapore office. Thanks, Frans.
You're welcome.
Hey, Sharon, how are you today?
Hi, Sven, I'm good.
Hey, I have heard that you are using condition monitoring at one of our customers. Can you please share your experience with us?
Yeah, that's true, Sven. We have been using it from the last couple of months on a small scale to test the value of the system.
And can you then also share what kind of values that you see? What are the benefits that you experience?
Yeah, sure, indeed. Basically, it gives actual insight into a condition instead of doing inspections, which allows to replace a component such as motor before it stopped working. So in the end, we hope to predict all the failures in order to limit the downtime of the system, which is key to the operations.
So in the end, you help to make sure that passenger and back travel at the same time. Thanks for that, Sharon. Thanks for your insights.
Thank you.
I think this was an interesting conversation with Sharon and also with Erik, Rutger and Frans. We have learned a lot more about how we use data to prevent operational downtime. I can imagine you have a lot more questions to ask. I even hope so, and please feel free to do so. For now, thank you for watching. Do not forget to hit the like button
and see you next time.